this is a review from yesterday. We have already done this, so should be in your notes. You should be able to, even better than tell me the answer, you should be able to tell me exactly why the answer is the answer. So who can tell me how quickly the glass is filling with water and how you figured it out? Jaden?
It's filling 4 centimeters every 2 seconds.
4 centimeters every 2 seconds. How did you figure that out?
I subtracted... I subtracted 5 from 7, and I got 2.
So you figure out how many seconds passed?
Yeah. Right?
7 seconds, minus 5 seconds.
And then...
That's 2 seconds that this thing took.
I subtracted 12 from 16.
Okay, so 16 minus 12, you did that. So you figured out how many centimeters did it increase, and how much time did it take, and that is... Answer the question. How fast is it filling? 4 centimeters every 2 seconds. Can we say that differently? More simply?
Yeah.
How?
2 centimeters every 1 second.
2 centimeters every 1 second. Alright. Kind of nice. Think of it as every 1 second. So 2 centimeters every 1 second. And then I'm asking you, how high was it at 0 seconds? Right? This is at 5 seconds, but if we go back to 4, 3, 2, 1, 0 seconds. How high is the water at that time? And in addition to that, in addition to the answer, how did you find the answer? Why don't you give it to us last time? Someone who gives it to us this time?
It was 1 centimeter
at 0
seconds.
How did you come to that answer?
Because I did what?
So you did it, subtracted it from what?
Yeah, from
2
and
1.
From 2 and 1?
So you took 2 centimeters per 1 second, you took 2 centimeters minus 1 second. I don't know about that, because centimeters and seconds are different things, right? Like apples and oranges. So we can't take seconds away from centimeters. Think less about the computations that you have to do. Think more about a glass filling with water. Right? And think about going back, using the information you have, going back in time, rewinding the video, letting the water go back down to where it was at 0 seconds. How could we figure out how high it was at 0 seconds? Come back 4 centimeters from 12?
Yeah.
Why 4 centimeters?
Because that's what we got for the answer of how much it's increasing.
4 centimeters. But 4 centimeters every 2 seconds. How many seconds do we need to go back in time?
2.
Just 2?
Yeah.
4, 5.
5. 5, right? Why 5?
Because you have to get to 0.
But to get to 0, and where can we start?
5.
You can start at 5 seconds. We can start at 7 seconds. That'd be silly, right? We can already go back to 5.
We've already done it.
Yeah. So what? Why start at 7? Let's start at 5. Right? So when you start at 5, then you go back, right? And every second we go back, it's how many centimeters? It's 2 for every 1 second, right? 4 for every 2 seconds. And if we needed to go back an even number of seconds, that'd make that easy. But we need to go back an odd number of seconds. So let's go back 1 second at a time. We go back 1 second, and how high is the water?
10.
And back one more?
9.
8. Back another second. Back another second.
4.
And then the last second.
2
centimeters. Right? So we start at 12. Right? Good idea. Start there. And go back from there. Go back, right? Subtract. Reverse time. Now, instead of going back 1 second at a time, can we just calculate how many centimeters it must have gone in those 5 seconds?
Yes.
How can we do that? Someone other than Hunter, I'm sure, has the answer to this question. How can we just calculate if it's 2 centimeters for every second, we need to go back 5 seconds, how can we calculate how many centimeters we would have to go back down? that?
Divide
what?
Divide
5 by 2. What's 5 divided by 2 going to tell you? 5 seconds divided by 2, because it's 2 centimeters a second? Well, 5 divided by 2, that's 2.5.
Have we gone, I think we just go down 2.5 centimeters?
I think I caught you on a sleepy day, guys. I know this is not typical. All right, 2 centimeters per second. Okay, we need to go back a total of 5 seconds. In 1 second, how far will the water go?
2 centimeters
in 1 second. In 2 seconds, how many centimeters will go?
4.
In 3 seconds, okay? Does this sound like 5 divided by 2 or?
1
times 2. 2 times 5. 2 centimeters a second times 5 seconds. It's going to go down a total of how many centimeters?
10 centimeters.
So 12 minus 10? Started at 2 centimeters. So like we were to put this in a table where x is seconds and y is the height of the water. At 0 seconds, how many centimeters?
Was it 2?
Okay, starts at 0 seconds, it starts at 2 centimeters. Okay? In 1 second from there, in 1 second, how high will the water be?
4 centimeters.
4 centimeters.
In 2 seconds from then?
6, and so on and so forth.
And so on and so forth. I'm going to jump ahead to
15
seconds. In 15 seconds, how high will the water be? I want you to tell me how high it is and how you figured it out. Actually, you know, tell me the calculation that needs. Myla?
30.
And how did you get that?
Times 15 by 2.
2 times 15, and what's that going to tell you?
Well, there's 2 centimeters every second.
Right.
So, if you do that by 15, then you get 30.
You get 30, but there's just a little bit, something more than that, right? Because the 2 times 15, that just tells me how far up the water goes, right? Right?
Yeah.
It tells me that it goes up how many centimeters? How many centimeters is it going to increase? Over 15 seconds, how many centimeters is it going to increase?
30.
But how high was this to start with?
2.
So is there a little bit more to this?
Gonna
yeah.
Start, it's going to be
32. We got a 2 from the beginning. We add on those 30 that it increases over those 15 seconds, and we get 32. Okay.
Okay.
Now, how about after 23 seconds? Who can tell me after 23 seconds how high the water is? 48. Okay. Well, Marcus was the first one to just shout it out. How did you figure that out? 2 times 23. Why 2 times 23? Is that 46? But you said 48. Why is it 48? Why are you adding on 2? It started at 2. You always have to have that extra 2. You calculate how far it goes up, but you always started at 2, so you add on the 2. So that's 48. Okay. Here's the thing that everybody's going to work on right now in their papers, in their notes. If you haven't written anything down, That's a really, really bad idea. You should have written down so many things by now. Okay, there's a lot up there, and you should have it written in your notes. Start improving today. If you don't take very good notes, take better notes starting today. Okay? Now, what I want you to do in your notes is tell me after X seconds, can you like put X into some kind of an equation that when you plug in any number for X, for the number of seconds that have gone by, then it will calculate how high the water is. Okay? And these two guys right here are going to be really helpful hints in figuring that out. Okay, so we figured out after, let's just jump to 15. When I'm talking, you're not talking, unless I ask you a question. Right? After 15 seconds, oh, it said 2 times 15, because 2 centimeters every second for 15 seconds is 30 centimeter increase plus the 2 that we started with, 32. For 23 seconds, the same thing, except 2 times 23 plus 2. So if I want to write an expression with x in it, where basically I can take x out of the expression and replace it with any number, what would that expression look like? So they can replace x with any number of seconds, and it'll tell me the height.
Try doing 2 plus 2 times x equals 64.
Now why 64?
I just randomly chose a number for x, and then times that by 2, and then added 2, and then I got 64.
Okay, so let's say that this equals y, okay? We don't want it, it's not always going to, like, if there's an x there, it's not always going to come out to be 64, right?
Mm-hmm.
It will only come out to be 64 if we put a very specific number in for x, right?
Yeah.
But if it's x, then it's a variable, it's not a number yet, right? It's just standing in place of a number.
Mm-hmm.
So let's test it with the number that you chose. What number did you choose to plug in for x?
31.
So if we do take x and replace it with 31, and we're saying after 31 seconds, how high is the water? Let's see if that works out. 2 plus 62, 64. Would we all agree that the height of the water would be 64 after 31 seconds?
Yes.
Yeah, it would be. Right. That's exactly what we would do. 2 times the amount of seconds, because 2 centimeters per second times the number of seconds, plus the 2 that we started with would give us whatever the height is. So this is an equation with variables, where it's saying any time can be plugged in here, and that will find the height at that time. So leaving variables. We don't want to say 64, because 64 would mean that x is always 31, which it isn't. It could be anything. You see what I mean by making it y
is 64? Is she just, like, picking numbers, or is she, like, going, like, with numbers that are going to be...
31, you just picked it kind of randomly, right?
Yeah.
31, you just picked it kind of randomly. Well, however you did it, in the end,
yeah.
This is what I was looking for.
Right.
An equation that can be, it can have any time plugged into it and give you the height at that time.
Right.
If you just have something with a number there, it doesn't do that. It just is a number. Like this right here. 2 plus 2 times 23 equals 48. It's an example of finding how high the water is at 23 seconds, but it's not an equation that I can use to, or a formula that I can use to plug in any number I want for the time and get out the height at that time. That make sense? This is what I want. I want a formula, or I want an equation that gives me the height at any time. Seems like there's some confusion. I see some confusion on faces.
Nope.
On all faces. What questions do we have about this equation? Or you can think of it as a formula. A formula that I plug in the time and it gives me the height.
Yeah.
Any questions? Because we're just going to keep doing this, so you might as well ask your question.
What did he say?
Oh, everything.
He said it was easy.
This is not easy.
What's the confusion poll? I asked for people to say what they're confused about poll, that you should feel free to jump in there and tell me what you're confused about. Why is there two?
No, I mean like 2 plus 2. Why is there an extra 2?
Which 2 are you calling extra? Is this the extra 2?
I don't know. One of them.
Why is
it?
Yeah.
Just one.
Why is there just 2? Shouldn't there only be 1?
I thought it was supposed to be 12 minus 2 times.
All right. Here, let's boil it down. The information that we gathered was this. There's a glass. It's being filled with water. And through being told where it is at 5 seconds and 7 seconds, we figured out that 2 pieces of information, it started, right? By started, I mean at 0 seconds. At 0 seconds, there were already 2 centimeters of water. Like, it was just, it's like a glass. It was just sitting there with some water in it, just sitting there. Right?
Yeah.
Then we start to fill it up. So far, so good?
Yeah.
So we fill up this cup. It's already got 2 centimeters of water. We're going to start adding some water in there. How fast are we adding the water? Like, how fast is the water, the height going up?
12.
How fast is the height of the water changing?
2 centimeters.
So it's going up
2 centimeters per second.
2 centimeters every second. So every second that goes by, it goes up 2 centimeters.
Yeah.
Am I confused about that?
No, that's like the only part I got in the
resume. Okay. 2 centimeters every second. So in 1 second, it's going to go up 2 more. Another second, it's going to go up 2 more. Another second, it's going to go up 2 more. Right. Every second that goes by, it goes up 2 centimeters.
Okay.
So then, ultimately, what I wanted to figure out was, what's an equation that x represents the time and y represents the height? And when I say an equation, I'm asking, like, if I give you a time, what would you do with that time to figure out how high the water is? Okay, so I started out by giving you some examples. If, you know, if it's 10 seconds. At 10 seconds, how high is the water? Cool. Starts at 2,
and be
at 0 seconds, at 2 centimeters. So 10 seconds later, how high is it?
20.
Whoa.
22. Oh, yeah, because you had to add 2.
Okay, so there's the adding of the 2. The adding of the 2. And you said 20 just a second ago. How did you find 20?
Because every second it goes up 2.
So how did you get
2?
So 2 times what?
10.
10. Is 20.
Plus 2 is 20.
Plus the 2.
Oh.
There's your extra 2. I don't know which one you're calling extra, but there's why both of those 2's exist.
Okay.
2 centimeters per second times 10 seconds, we're going to add that to the 2 centimeters we had to start with. Right? Okay, Hallie. After 14 seconds, how high is the water?
30.
And how do you get there?
14 times
2
plus
2. 2 times 14 plus what? 2. Plus the 2 we started with, right? And so that comes out to be, well, we didn't write this. This comes out to be what?
30.
30. Okay. Bella? After 17 seconds? How high would the water be after 17 seconds? Wouldn't you? Yeah, I mean, why change it up? It's been working. We need to figure out how high it goes. Like, what? How much does it rise? And then we add it to the 2 that we started with. How much does it rise? Add it to the 2 we started with. So let's calculate how much it rise or rose after 17 seconds. How do we calculate how much it rose in total after 17 seconds?
Let's just do 2 plus 2.
Now why this part? Why 2 times 17?
Because that's
that's how much it goes up. And why this tube?
Because that's where it started.
Less confusing now?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So the last step here was, right, can we do that for any number of seconds?
Yeah.
That's the first question.
Sure.
And as Bella said, wouldn't we just do the same thing? Right? With any number of seconds? What would we do? Like, what would be the process for figuring out how far it went up? You just take 2 times what?
X.
Because X represents what?
Any number.
Any number of seconds, yeah. 2 times any number of seconds. And we'd add that to the 2 that we started with. Okay. So this equation here will give us the height at any time X. So let's jump to the next page here.
Yay.
This one seems a little tricky. This is the one that I said I wanted you to take home.
Yes.
Okay. I decided this homework was really, I just wanted you to be ready for us to talk about this today.
Wait, this is homework?
Yeah. I said it was. I'm not going to collect it. I'm not going to grade it. I just wanted you to prepare for today.
Oh.
And if I don't tell you that it's homework, it won't do it.
Yeah.
Even if I tell you it is homework, it doesn't mean you're going to do it. So it's the best weapon I have.
Darn.
So I want you, if you didn't do it for homework, then I want you to do it now. Given this information, very similar to the information we had back here, how quickly is the glass filling with water? That's what I want you to figure out. Okay, so how quickly is it filling? First of all, is there anything a little bit weird about that wording?
It's draining, isn't it?
So it's not filling.
No, it's draining.
Okay. All right, so let's think of it that way for a minute. Stop talking.
Okay.
So it's not filling, right? Because the higher level is at the earlier time, and 3 seconds later, it's lower than it was before. Which means like there must be a hole in this thing, right? And it's draining out. Okay, so how could we say how quickly that's happening?
Quickly.
How quickly?
3 seconds.
Okay, it's happening in 3 seconds. What happens in 3 seconds?
Increasing 9 centimeters.
It goes down 9 centimeters. Okay, but if I say 9 centimeters every 3 seconds, or 3 centimeters every second, well, that doesn't quite fit the situation, does it?
No, sure.
Because that makes it sound like it's going up 3 centimeters every second. But it's going down 3 centimeters every second.
Negative 3.
Negative, yeah.
Yeah.
So if we did our subtraction that we did before, we did 16 minus 2 and 7 minus 5. Okay. Well, if we wanted to figure out how many seconds went by, it went 5 minus 2. 5 seconds minus 2 seconds is the 3 seconds. But at that 5 seconds, it was actually at 22 centimeters minus the 31 that it was at 2 seconds. It was actually a negative 9 centimeters. So negative 9 centimeters every 3 seconds, or negative 3 centimeters every second. Right? And if I ask the question again, and we look at the answer, how quickly is it filling with water? Would you say that it works? It's filling negative 3 centimeters per second.
Yeah.
How fast is it going up? Well, it's going up in a negative way. It's going down, actually. Right? So the rate is actually a negative rate. We're losing centimeters every second.
If you were worried if a positive telling, would it still be negative or would it be positive?
It would actually turn out to be positive, because if I said how fast is the glass emptying?
Decreasing?
Going
not really much of a way to say that.
I just don't understand. I think that's how you would spell
it. I don't think it's
emptying.
A word.
Emptying's a loser.
Emptying.
So to Bella's question, if I wanted to know how fast is it emptying? Well, it is emptying. It is emptying in a positive way, right? How much are we losing? 9 centimeters every 3 seconds. 3 centimeters every 1 second. So
that's a lot.
I have to ask it as filling to get so that you have to have a negative rate, and that's what I wanted to have happen. I wanted you to get a negative rate. So it's going down. It's going negative. We're losing centimeters every second. So if we're losing 3 centimeters every second, and we at 2 seconds had 31 centimeters of water, how high was it at 0 seconds?
9 feet.
Is that?
9 centimeters.
Negative 3 seconds.
Well, at 0 seconds, it was negative 3 centimeters.
0 seconds, it was negative 3 centimeters?
Yes.
So at 0 seconds, negative 3 centimeters would be... would be down here. There's like negative 3 centimeters is below the bottom of the glass.
Can we end?
Can we zero them?
You get out.
Yeah, no, you get out when they tell you get out. So stop it and keep paying attention. It is out, exactly how it works. Okay? So how high was the water at 0? At 2 seconds, right? This is 2 seconds after 0 seconds, right? Was it higher than that or lower than that at 0 seconds?
Lower.
Higher.
Must have been higher. It's empty.
Yeah, higher.
Okay. Then where was it? It was higher. 1, 2 seconds ago. How high was it?
35.
40. 37. How'd you get 37?
Sorry,
In one second. Yeah. Stop crumpling, stop backing up, listen to James. The longer this takes, the longer it takes.
Each second it goes backwards, it goes up 3.
Okay, so 1 second is 3 centimeters, another second is 3 more centimeters.
So, but if we're going backwards 2 seconds, you would just add 6 to before it went back in time.
Okay.
So you get it going to 0.
31 seconds plus 3 centimeters every second times 2 seconds, and you go back 2 seconds. Right? So we have 31 plus 6. 7. All right,
cool.
All right, goodbye. Have a good day.